Is that, that's a percent? Okay, we're calling this meeting to order at 1730 hours.
That's right. We're doing it right now.
I've been sitting next to George long enough.
There's no question about whether this is morning or afternoon.
And you subtract 12 from it to get the time that I'm used to. I know, I like that.
Yeah, there you go.
So, thank you. Hi, Rose, long time no see. Hi, Nancy. Public communication, public comment? I'm putting you on the spot, Rose. You don't have anything. Nance? Yes, that's true.
I have some budget questions, but that's the next meeting, correct?
Okay, that sounds good. Okay, thank you. Then, our students.
No student reports this time.
No students, just, is it, there was some real confusion with the meetings this month.
I would suggest that the day, you know, the, what meeting it is for them is getting a little confusing.
Yes, it is very confusing.
Yeah, so is it a SD meeting, is it a VUHS meeting? And I've not been good about reminding them about their expectations.
Would you like me to do that?
No, we'll get back on track next month.
So what if?
We had said there were no reports for the February meeting, so I think they view that as being off the hook.
Oh, they do?
Should we just start asking them to come to the SD?
Well, one is transitioning off, and we'll be looking for a new one. And I think we're again having a conversation about what is their role.
Okay. So you're not ready to do that jump yet?
I'd like to have a conversation with my superintendent about it.
I think that is a great idea. Thank you very much.
She's learning.
That was good.
It is good. I like that a lot. No student reps. The superintendent report we saw last night. Does anybody have any questions on that?
Some of us are. Hi, Tom.
No questions? Thank you. Principal's report, we didn't get one.
No.
Do we have one? You want to just give us a verbal one?
Things are great.
Things are great. Thank you.
We're talking about principals, I have a question. I was coming up Main Street at about 3 o'clock, and it was too far away to see what the actual item transpired, but there was a school bus that said VUHS on it when I got close to it that was stopped with its red lights flashing on Main Street, and I didn't think that we transported anybody within the city of Vergennes.
So the buses, do you want me to take this one?
Yeah, go for it.
As the buses are coming into Vergennes, they do make a couple stops right on the edge. So was it up near Panton Road?
No, it was right after you turn the corner up here, about 200 yards up the road.
It was
on Main Street, just around the corner? Wow.
Was it morning or afternoon?
3 o'clock this afternoon.
I mean, sometimes we do have students that if they're on the route of a bus, that they will get dropped off in some places. But usually there's prior arrangements made, and it's not something that happens regularly.
The bus was headed back this way, so it had been someplace.
So we do have an after-school bus. It depends on what time. It was 3 o'clock?
Just about 3 o'clock when I left the district office.
And did it say 973 on it?
That I don't know.
It's Jackie Terry. That
says Vergennes Union High School in white letters on a black.
Jackie Terry's bus says Vergennes Union High School on it, but she is the driver, primary driver for Vergennes Elementary School.
Okay.
So she would be, she picks up all the students within Vergennes.
Oh, okay.
K-6. So that may be what you were seeing at 3 o'clock.
I didn't realize that there was any bus transportation within the city.
Yeah, not for 7 through 12.
Yeah.
There is for elementary.
Right.
There is for elementary.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. Any other questions?
It was great that the cheerleading team won.
I know. I brought the paper. It's so exciting.
That's not a question, it's a statement.
It was great, yeah, it was absolutely great, yeah.
That is really cool.
Those big tournaments, and I mean, being able to host those events, I think it's really important for the community to be able to. We take a lot of pride in being able to do that and host those. There is a, you know, there is a cost to a certain degree. I mean, you know, you just think about 3,000 people here and toilet paper and paper towel kind of cost, yeah. But.
Plus the floor of the gym.
The floor of the gym, right, yeah.
Thank you, Mr. Facilities Committee.
But you know, we're proud that we are able, and we are asked to do that, and that's important. It's also, you know, a source of revenue because the boosters gear up and start selling stuff, and student groups sell stuff, and you know, I'm sure it extends to the community. You bring that many people in, and you know, they're shopping, they're stopping at Shaw's, they're doing all kinds of things like that. So I'm very pleased that we're able to do that.
Thank you.
How often, how do we do this, like once a year, once every?
Last week was they had the Vermont State Wrestling Tournament.
Yeah, I was going to say, the wrestling tournament. We've held that a couple of times, right?
Cheerleader, yes.
Yeah.
I would personally like to, for the board, congratulate Brandon Kusnak. For state championship.
Did he?
Yes.
132?
180.
182.
182?
Like a house. It's 182.
You're freaking kidding.
No.
Wow.
And he also got Outstanding Sportsmanship Award for the year by the officials.
Cool.
He's a great kid. He's a great kid.
So, I mean, 2 weekends in a row, we held 2 major competitions here. Pretty exciting.
Yeah, and there's well over. There was almost 360 matches this past weekend. There was, I would say, speculate, just, I didn't count the people here, but I would say well over 500, 600 people came through the door.
1,000.
I mean, it was 2 days.
Yeah, 3,000.
Wow.
My eyes were on the mat, so I mean, time is a thing. But I know the flip the duck or toss the duck was a big hit, and project graduation ended up with 3 digits. I forgot the exact number, but they ended up with $160 or $170 worth of money for that. So, chuck a duck. It was a big hit, and it was something that we've never seen in a wrestling facility function. So it was really good.
The kids ran it for a
$100.
Project graduation did it.
Yeah.
And then you throw them, you're supposed to get it to the closest place in the center of the court or the mat or whatever, whoever gets it the closest wins half the money.
Oh.
It's like a 50-50 raffle,
that's awesome.
But it's with ducks.
It's far more entertaining than a 50-50 raffle.
Yeah,
a lot more entertaining.
They do it at basketball.
That's awesome.
But to answer your question, Tom, we've the dance and cheerleading competition state championships we've hosted for probably dance for maybe 5 years and cheerleading for 7 or 8 years. Every year, mm-hmm. at the same time we host it.
So did we bid on that? I mean, how did that?
I don't know how we first got it, but we keep doing such a great job that
venue comes open and we'll do it.
I'm sure they just looked for a place that was, you know, kind of centrally located and had the facilities to support that.
Principals
Association, yeah.
I mean, the wrestling tournament switches every year. Last year it was at Mill River. Year before it was Middlebury, so they kind of go north-south.
Mm-hmm. I will entertain a motion to congratulate Brandon, who's no, for his state win and also the cheerleaders. Somebody indulge me?
Second.
You move. I'll second.
Thank you.
Sorry.
Thank you. No, that's fine. I probably wasn't as clear as I could have been. Is there any discussion? All of those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Passed. Thanks. Pass our congratulations on this. Super awesome. Thank you. All right. Business manager, local financials. Any questions?
Anything seem unusual this month, Tanya?
No. Everything is right on track.
Is
Stephanie once again is doing a fabulous job in matching her expenses.
Wait, what? I couldn't hear you.
Stephanie again is doing a fabulous job in watching her expenses.
Thank you.
Well, the winter's cooperating too.
Yep.
So the 409 of the budgetary, of the expenditures, that's just unencumbered. We're probably going to spend that. That's a question. Do you understand what my question is? Should I say it again?
Yeah, most of it's in general instruction, and you know, there's a large chunk there for the sped bill backs and other things that happen in the springtime that.
That we haven't budgeted before, and now we have.
We've budgeted for, but we just haven't spent them yet, okay. And they're not encumbered yet.
Okay. And the $65,000, almost $66,000 in transportation aid, is that just in the wrong account?
No, that's where it is, but okay. You still collect, this year is your last year to collect the transportation aid. Next year it goes to the SU or SD. And then, so it wasn't clearly stated by the state that we were to get it at the individual schools, because last year we actually paid for it all out of the SU.
Right.
And the money is supposed to follow where the bills go. So it offsets the over expenditure in your transportation assessment.
There's nothing in the transportation expenditures.
It's all under your district services, and nothing yet because it's not overspent yet because we haven't collected it all.
But it's not an additional revenue that we weren't expecting.
It is.
It is additional revenue we weren't expecting.
Yes.
What?
I was expecting it to go to the SU.
Okay, so the SU is going to have a negative amount of revenue, a reduction in their revenue, we have an increase. So it's a wash.
Technically, yes.
Okay. Did you?
No, I don't guess so.
You don't guess so?
I was just trying to follow you.
It's also the same issue with the vocational transportation reimbursement.
Mm-hmm.
It's still going to come to the school for this year, but next year it's going to go to this.
Thanks. So you're thinking we're going to come out
fine again?
Pretty good.
We're
that's good.
Barring any unforeseen circumstances, Stephanie should do very well.
Good. Thank you.
No pressure there.
Sorry. Okay. So I'm not sure this is the right place to ask, but I'm going to ask this. Maybe, should I? Can I? So, in the financial statements for the fund balances, this is on page 9, and I can show it to you if you want, Tanya. But there, in the general fund, there's this thing called non-spendable. For VUHS, it's only $2,756. But Addison has $100,000.
That's the amount that they're using in this year's budget to lower their taxes.
Oh, okay. Okay.
What does the category non-spendable mean?
It means it's committed to other areas at this point. It's part of your fund balance, okay, at the end of 16, but part of that fund balance we've already put into a budget for 17.
I see. Okay.
So as of 16, it's there, but it's committed other places. So it's unspendable.
So if we have $2,700 that's unspendable at the high school, according to what Lori just said.
It could have been a prepay from, you know, we paid it in 16.
Yeah.
But it's actually a 17 bill.
I see.
So it's, you know, it sure, could have been, we sure, prepaid sure. It in 16, it, yeah, so yeah. It's affecting the fund balance, but.
Fiscal years suck.
Yeah, well, yeah. Try living in three.
Fiscal years. It's
They're
a terrible
hard.
System.
Mm-hmm.
That's
hard.
Just my own personal opinion for
I mean, and we're talking about a budget that's almost 2 years in front of us, right? The one that's up for the, it's so gosh darn confusing. Okay. I'm going to just throw this out because we don't have the SD board is what warned the the budget and also the capital account, but we have a potential problem with that, and I didn't know if this board wanted to weigh in, because we're going to be going out into the community. It appears that it's possible that we may not have any surplus available for that capital improvement fund. Possible.
I think that you should have an offline discussion with Joanne. If you want to take a break and do that, it might be appropriate.
I forwarded my response to the board. Laurie got that too.
I did.
You did?
Yes, I did. Yeah, I did.
Okay.
I guess I'm just, you guys are all board members. You guys are all in the community. I just wondered, I would like your opinion to see if we should be communicating to the community through the press that we used numbers that weren't final, but it was all we had, and now come to find out it's not going to happen. Should we just...
Clarification for me, we're talking about the $100,000 separate article that was never moved and sat in the fund balance, so it's not like it's missing or it's just in the wrong place.
Yes, absolutely.
And if you consider it in the 16 audit, where were ye, if I read this correctly, there's $225,000 from what I read here. It's 125 and 100. We just miscategorized it. We didn't move it.
Yeah.
Not missing. It's not going for its intended purpose. However, it is being used, in my opinion, I could defend it, to reduce taxes. So maybe we didn't do it 100% right, but I personally don't have any, I could defend that.
Okay.
I could argue against anybody saying, well, how'd you do that? Well, it happens.
Okay.
And it's there, it was authorized.
We were going with numbers that we were given. We didn't know any better.
Yep. And I think we've been pretty clear that we've been seeking a restatement of the prior year for as long as I've been here. So it's not a mystery that we were one unhappy with a two-year-old audit. Mm-hmm. To answer your question, should you be communicating that electronically or in print or... I don't see the necessity for that, but
I appreciate that.
In the sense that saying more can sometimes mean that it brings attention to a lot of people's, puts it on their radar in a way that, but by not saying anything also can be like you're trying to hide something. And
exactly.
Just how do you say it in a way that's simple and that's straightforward, that can be accurate, that is easily digestible by the vast majority of...
I think so. That's a very good point. This is difficult accounting stuff.
Yeah, I think our best move is we understand what happened, and if somebody asks, we can all explain that to them.
Okay. I appreciate that. Do you have an opinion, Roger? Richard? Excuse me, sorry.
I don't understand what happened, but I'm not in the know.
So. Okay. All right. How about you, Tom?
I generally agree with Greg. I now understand what happened. I think my concern at this point is more about moving forward, and the warned 100,000 was for the capital improvement fund for the district, not for the high school, since we don't do that anymore.
That's right.
It was described on the basis of thinking there was a surplus that was larger than it is. And so I'm unclear about the tax implications of that if that passes. I would like to have that pass, but that's, so I have a lack of clarity moving forward, not a lack of clarity moving backward.
Do you want to say it? Okay, so the lawyer said, if we don't have a surplus, even though the community voted it in, if we don't have a surplus, we cannot transfer the funds, period, end of question. So whatever surplus we end up with, we'll transfer up to 100,000 if it passes. Otherwise, none of it will go.
Otherwise,
we have
none
no
of it passes.
Surplus.
Got it.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So the outstanding issues are whether we need to repay those two capital improvement funds, that's still outstanding, and what the actual net surplus is after we make the adjusting entry for the 140. And also determine whether these, we also have to take into account these non-spendable or committed funds out of that surplus as well.
Can I ask for some clarification? Tom, you said that the $100,000 that was in the 15-16, $100,000 for capital improvement was destined for the D? No. Okay. I thought that's what I heard.
Destined for the high school.
Destined for the high school.
Correct. The 15-16.
So the one that we're voting.
The one that's out there now is destined for the district.
Yes. Everything else is for the high school. The one that's out there. So there is 200. There will be 240,000 that's dedicated to the high school. This is my understanding. And
that's
moving,
how it was designed.
And moving forward, it's all in the hands of the SD.
Yeah.
So whatever they vote in and we have surplus for, will go to the SD.
But the $100,000 that we're talking about occurred in 15-16?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Right.
So there was 40,000 in FY15 that was voted in.
Right.
That was never transferred.
That was the seed money. And
right.
Then the
100,000 in 16. And that
another.
Journal entry got missed. And then there's 100,000 in 17
right.
that I've made the journal entry for. So okay. Now there's a balance in there.
Right. So it was designed to produce 240 over three.
And it has. I have spoken to the auditors, and we are moving that. And
so you're moving
the high school.
So you've got 140 in there now instead of 240.
It's going to be 240.
But where's that 100 that you're going to move? Where's it coming from? Where's it currently reside? In the general fund?
For which year?
I don't know which year you're going to get. That's what I guess.
You'll probably be the only one that understands this, but the auditor told me that for the 15, the 40,000 in 15, I need to debit the fund balance, credit the fund balance in the general fund, and debit the fund balance for the CIP account.
Yep.
Okay.
Will lower your balance forward or affect your balance forward because it sits in the cash balance of the general fund.
Yes.
So if you got a deficit, it's going to make it worse.
Yes.
But Lori just said you can't move money from a deficit position. So anyway, continue. All right, I'm following you. You're going to debit and credit and create a new fund and put it seed money
strictly in. Through the general fund accounts. 16, I book the expenditure as the capital improvement transfer for 100,000, and then I credit the revenue for the CIP fund, and then I do the same thing for the 17. With 17. Doing that, I'm sorry.
17 is coming this year, but towards the end, June, July.
Yeah. Well, I'm gonna actually make the journal entry this week, so I get them all cleaned up because. In May, I have my preliminary audit starting.
Okay.
So I want those things done so we don't miss them again.
Okay, so if you fully seed that capital improvement fund and get 240 in it, then the audit statement that they just gave us, the restated one, is erroneous.
We are requesting that all board members send back their books, if you have a book, and we will reissue those books when we receive the final report.
Okay. So my two cents here, this is not the end of the world. this, I mean, I don't want to say this happens, but these are journal entries, and they normally accompany the end of the year or whatever. And if you don't get them, you don't make them. And if you don't make them, you end up with this. My point here is, if Tanya and the office doesn't have journal entries to close the year, which started the whole discussion for the 15 audit, this is what you end up with. No blame here, as far as I'm concerned.
Okay.
That was not a paid political announcement.
two questions. One is interest on the capital improvements funds. Is that something that gets accrued? Do we get that interest?
There's no interest on it.
Even though it's cash sitting around? So there's no...
It's not sitting in its own separate bank account collecting interest. It's in your cash account, and it's strictly the fund accounting way of, you know, you have one bank account, but it's split into...
So it's not typical to allocate interest to it?
Nope.
I would be shocked if you netted $1,000 from last year with your $10 million, but I would be shocked to see that number. Because it's a sweep account. It constantly clears it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
So it's not sitting anywhere for a long period of time.
And then the 40K, are they going to restate the beginning balances to get that 40K in? Or is that coming?
That's all happening in the 16 year. So there's just going to restate. They don't want to restate 15 again for $40,000.
So they're going to make the adjusting entry for the 140 in 16.
Yes.
Hence, the documents that are most important are these ones that we're going to throw away and you're going to give us new ones.
Correct.
Which I think are our fodder for our argument. That if the auditors are providing us new documents on a monthly basis, every quarter, I mean, to me, that's your, I don't think you need a defense, but to me, that's your discussional document right there. They keep restating all the way back to 14, 15. And 15, 16, twice. And 16 and 17, twice. Of course, we haven't finished yet.
So effectively, we're still in the cleanup. This is, in a sense, the detritus and the cleanup. Though we've done a lot of work, we've moved far ahead, this is still the cleanup of 4 years ago.
Yeah, we just peeled off another layer of the onion and found this.
To me, this is, I would argue this is a whole separate animal because I think this is a byproduct of maybe a poor audit, which is a byproduct of just a bad group of people coming in here doing audits. Now, was it fed by just turmoil when the ladies got here? Probably was. But, you know, garbage in, garbage out.
Yeah.
Poor audit. The auditors we hired last year knew it as soon as they got here.
But to be a simpleton here, and I will be asked town meeting day, because it is known that we put a thing on the thing for $100,000. The layman person is going to ask, what are we doing with it, or where is it? And I as a layman, don't understand your accounting jargon. And they in Patton ain't going to either. But
so the when you get asked about it at town meeting for the FY18 budget, because mm-hmm. it'll be an article on there.
Right.
It will be whatever we have for a surplus at the end of 16, if we have a surplus, that amount will be transferred into a capital improvement account for the entire school district.
Okay.
But up to $100,000.
Up to $100,000, because that's what we're voting on.
Yes.
Okay, that's fine. But currently, we may not want to live in the past, but many people do.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and especially when they talk about money. So I don't have any papers with me, but supposedly somewhere in the accounting enigma, there's 240 at the end of when you think for capital gains, for capital projects for this building.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And that money will be used for this building, not district wide.
Correct.
Okay, that's all I want to make, because that's one of the questions I was asked is, you know, especially with when we had the furnace issue. I mean, I was asked, well, I thought we had this thing, what's going on? I said, it's being worked on, it's being taken care of. But I just want to make sure that, because the other, right after they got done asking that question, they said, Well, all that money that we approved for the high school, because that has been neglected, is that money all of a sudden going to go to the district and it's not going to be in this building? And I said, I can't do that.
That's part of the Articles of Agreement that we agreed upon to form a new school district, that the money is generated for the purposes of that individual school will remain there until the school district proposes a budget and that gets passed. Right. Then it becomes district-wide.
Okay. That's fine. I'm like many other people. I don't read the whole document, so I'm not going to, so they're just, they hear about it. And they, you know, they're asking that specific say, because I guarantee, I have a funny suspicion that many of us over in Patton didn't realize there's a agreement document stating that the money generated here stays here, or here stays here. Now I know, so I can answer that question. Thank you.
So if you get to town meeting day, and that's Tuesday, right, and you are fielding questions that you can't answer, call the office.
Okay.
Call us, and we would be more than happy to support you.
Okay. Thank you.
Thanks. Any other questions on that piece? Thanks for your feedback. I really appreciate the candid conversation and your opinions. Facilities Committee.
So speaking thereof, we are meeting on Friday to consider using some of the $244,000. I think we've spent a long time trying to think about how it should be used, because there are lots and lots of different ways in which it could be used, but how it can be both husbanded and used effectively. And so on Friday, we are going to consider some proposals from Mrs. Taylor, and we will come back to the board in the March meeting, hopefully with a proposal to spend a portion of that money on things that aren't getting fixed through other means, which is the way we understand that fund to be of use.
Right.
And just, I know some of you know and some of you don't know, the energy performance contract, we only received one bid. It was put back out for bid, and hopefully we will receive multiple bids. The walkthrough is
tomorrow. And I have six companies signed up to be there.
Wow.
So
great.
Hopefully that will, we're hoping the furnace is going to last for another, and the distribution system will last for another year and a half, and that this will help be part of the plan moving forward. There will be more to report, I guess, on in the March meeting in 2 weeks.
Yeah, thank you. Okay. And it is, just to be clear, it's all four buildings that they're walking through.
Yes.
Okay. Anything else?
Nope.
Facilities Committee, any questions for him? Hannaford Career Center, Richard.
Hannaford Career Center, we've been spending the last couple meetings, basically, as probably you already know, Lynn is leaving in July. And so we've been, once we got the letter from the Secretary of Education saying they could hire a new superintendent, which was a total.
You had to get permission?
You do have to get permission.
You have to get permission. So, I mean, as someone that doesn't know all the thing, it was just blew my mind when that was aired. I'm like, really? Government at its best. But so that we got the letter, we've gone through with the school board association walking us through the process. We have formed a
search committee,
so to speak. It's not a hiring committee. It's a search committee, but we're not doing the search. We've hired somebody to do the search. Oh. We're actually doing, it's kind of like the step between the search and hiring. So,
are you on that committee, Richard?
I am on that committee.
So Stephanie's on the committee too.
Excellent. I am on that committee, and it's basically, and I'm terrible with names, but he's the consultant that we hired.
Bob Stevens.
Bob. There you go. Awesome presentation. Very impressed with. He actually talked down to where I could understand him.
He did. Joe answered.
Right, and then
that was
on one of the.
Sorry, that was very rude.
Yes.
Are you hanging your hat on that?
He gave an awesome presentation to us. on the 15th, we had a special meeting with him, and he gave an awesome presentation, and one of his references was the work that he did for getting hiring Joanne. So he was very, like I said, talked down, expect what we're, you know, gave us what were our expectations and how to treat candidates and stuff like that. That was really interesting to me, the whole concept in it. So yes, I'm on that committee, and that's where we're at. So that's basically all we've been doing for the last couple months.
May I ask, Joanne,
what's the timeline, Richard, for the process?
Right now, the ad the ad's in to the periodical, whatever, I forgot what the official periodical name is, but the ad's in, and we're start after this meeting, which will be not next coming Wednesday, but the following Wednesday. I'm hoping that they're going to start, because I have not heard any the schedule of the post search committee, if you will, when we're supposed to be starting those meetings. Okay. But Bob stated that there's five, possibly six, meetings on that process. So they're really hoping to be able to at least get an interim before Lynn leaves.
Good.
He's
Thank
been
you.
There a long time.
Yeah,
right?
He's a fixture.
Yeah, and that's going to be a rough transition, maybe. Maybe not.
It may be, it may not be, because I think Lynn has a great staff. Mm-hmm. His dean of students is, once again, I'm terrible with names, is an awesome.
Daniels.
Thank you, Kim. Thank you. I apologize. If my name wasn't on my license, I wouldn't remember it mine. She's a great person. She's very knowledgeable. And, you know, I think Lynn is an awesome guy, and, man, he's just an amazing individual, and I can sit there and listen to his stories and his ideas for hours. But I think part of his strong suit is he has a good staff underneath him, you know, the administration that's underneath him. The guy who's in charge of the adult education part is really on top of it and really does a lot that you really don't understand that would be out there with far as dealing with the community to get them involved in the continuing of the education for the adults. And we just this past year just hired a new business, so, and he seems to be on the ball too, so he's got a good staff, and it looks like it's going to be a learning experience for me, and I think it's very realistic that we will have somebody in place before July, because they really were pushing that before because of the consolidation and because a new person coming on the board and stuff like that, for not only for this place but for Middlebury and stuff like that.
Awesome.
So that's
thank
it.
You.
Yep.
Thank you very much. Any questions? Thank you, Richard. Board member reports.
Actually, I do have a quick question.
Oh,
are you done?
I'm done July.
You're done in July. Great. That was. I wasn't sure because I wasn't sure if your term ended in March.
No.
But you're done in July. So good. Thank you.
They're not fulfilling. My term does end in March technically, but since we consolidated, they're not. Last I knew, they're not.
And
not
you'll continue with this through. Great.
July.
Great. Thank you.
Right. And then the new representative for the district from Penn will be. Yeah. Representative Penn.
And then the SD board has to assign somebody at the organizational meeting, I would say. So just so this board knows, I did not get the information that I was supposed to run this year, or I would have, but I'm not on the ballot. I am going to say to the town if they'd like to write me in, they can, but I might not get elected, so one of you guys might be board chair. Lucky you.
Someone else is not running either.
Yeah.
Greg.
For 4 months, they'll appoint. I've agreed to have them appoint me like they did last time.
Good. Is that the city council that does it? Because
mm-hmm.
in Addison,
if nobody runs and nobody's filed a petition,
it's the city council.
It's the city council.
It's interesting because in Addison, it's the school board.
Mm-hmm.
I thought that
in
was very
Fairsburg
interesting.
It is, too.
Yeah. Interesting.
That's how I ended up here.
Yeah. And we are lucky you did.
Hence my hence my fears last night, you know? Find your replacement.
All right.
Any board member reports? Approval of minutes. I will entertain a motion to approve the minutes of December 21st as written.
So moved.
Thank you, Richard.
Second.
Second, Greg, thank you. Any discussion? Happy? Hearing none, all those in favor say aye.
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 Opposed? Thank you. Approval of director's orders. Do we have one?
We do.
Aha.
From December 21st through February 22nd in the amount of $1,562,640.82.
Wow.
So moved.
Second.
Any discussion?
Anything outstanding in that?
Let's have a couple of SU.
Couple of assessments.
Just two assessments? Because that's,
yep.
Two assessments is over 600 and.
Yeah. Two assessments and then, you know, other little stuff that, but.
Do you want her to pass it around so you guys just take a quick look?
Oh, and then there, you know, there's a couple of months of health insurance too, which is.
Which are big dollars.
Yeah.
That's like 75 a month or something, isn't
80.
It? 80 a month.
Yeah. I'm good.
Just for the high school.
I'm content.
Oh, and then there was the payment to the Hannaford for $436,000. So,
big chunk. That whittles it right down, doesn't it?
That wiped it right out.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
That was my comment because it seemed to be higher than it.
Right.
Yes, like,
well, this is also December, January, February. It's 3 months of it. Mm-hmm. 2.5 months of it. February 22nd.
Take the year and you divide what we spent over it. It's pretty close to, you know,
yeah,
going to match up month to month.
While I'm thinking about it, yes, Martha.
You haven't voted. You haven't voted.
Thank you. any other discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor say aye.
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 Opposed? Passed. Thank you.
Thank you,
Martha. Perhaps the next meeting or the one afterwards, we could have a quick overview of the accounts payable system. You and I, we talked about something, and I just thought it wouldn't be a bad idea for this board. And maybe it's the SD board that we should do it in. I don't know.
You know what? We're going to be doing fiduciary responsibilities, and it would be.
Maybe under that?
Yeah.
To have the accounts payable,
yep,
and how it works?
Yep.
In each school?
Yes.
Okay. All right, well, I can do that. We can do that. Yes, sir.
Not meaning to be difficult, but you're 13 minutes overtime.
Oh, am I?
Yes.
I apologize. I thought we had till 6:30. Appreciate that.
That's coffee clutch.
Thank you. Any other business? I'll take a motion to adjourn.
Before you do?
Yes.
Would you like to talk a little bit about the meeting and how we're going to handle it?
The annual meeting?
Yes.
Sure, why not?
We'll do that. So earlier I had a conversation with Jay and Laurie about how we're going to open this meeting, and even though Jay has a history of being the clerk, we could vote him as the moderator. That's really what we're supposed to do, is to vote up for a moderator. Jay will open the meeting.
The clerk
will open the meeting. We'll take nominations for moderator. We'll nominate Jay. Jay will preside. And really, the whole purpose of your annual meeting is to report out on the status of the school. So board members can take an opportunity to focus on what you think the school has accomplished over the year. And that's it. And then we adjourn. So it is very...
Public questions, too.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yes, we do take public questions, too. Yes. But those two pieces, and that's it.
And then would we follow that up with the budget informational meeting? Because that's what we've done in the past, is I would adjourn the annual meeting, and then we do, because I heard Nancy say she had some budget questions.
I think we can do that within the context of public comment.
However,
you are not the SD board.
The budget is by the SD board. That meeting was last night. That's where those questions should have been asked and answered.
Right.
But we do have public
this
here,
is not,
though.
I understand that, but that budget is not a product of this board.
We don't have anything to do with it here.
The challenge is that we didn't make it available. We didn't have a budget informational meeting last night.
We had an annual meeting in which the voters adopted the reports. Mm-hmm. And those reports had financials in them, mm-hmm. which also included the budget. And we did answer questions on the budget. Some questions on the budget.
So we're in transition, so there's a bit of confusion around.
I don't see why we can't
entertain questions about the budget, and if they can't be answered in the context of the people who are here, then I think it's okay to say they can't be answered in.
Well, if they can't be answered by the people here, we're in trouble.
No. I mean in the context of. I think clarifying when we're moving outside of the reins of the high school and when we're in the reins of the SD.
That's why you have Tanya and I here, and we'd be happy.
Yes, of course. And I mean, just I think being clear for the two people watching it, when we can make these statements or under which hat we are speaking at what moment is a useful thing. That's all I meant.
I think it would be helpful if Lori were to clarify that fact and just say, we didn't author this, but we're familiar, we're willing to talk, we're willing to do, you know, a dialogue with you. But again, Pat, just remember.
So let me make an additional clarifying. This is a public meeting and none of us have any roles. We are the public. You're the public. When we do this annual meeting, all of us are public people, and so we are really only responding from our public hats, right? And you guys are the administrators. You have, right. Does that make sense to you guys?
Just a point of clarification. So yes. In the past, mm-hmm. as the clerk, we've held the annual meeting.
Right.
I've taken notes on that, submitted those, but I adjourn, or the moderator has adjourned the annual meeting and then giving it over to the board chair
for the
budget informational meeting. So in that case, you're not the public.
Yeah, if you do that.
Right.
Right.
Which is how we've done it in the past. So I assume we've been doing it correctly in the past.
I would raise the question that, Jay, I think you're right. So you went from an informational into a budgetary discussion with a board that created
right.
the product in front of them. And as you said a minute ago, time of transition here. So is the budget meeting necessary because the budget wasn't created by this board, nor does this board have right. any priority in, we didn't. I mean, it wasn't created by us.
We missed that opportunity last night.
Yes.
Is what really happened.
That's true.
So. Yep. But I think because we know that we have some questions, I think it's reasonable to entertain those if people are willing to do that.
Lori can handle all of them.
Yeah.
thanks, Greg. No problem.
So in a performance mode, because we are the public, perhaps that means we should also be sitting with the public and not as the board, because when we're sitting as the board, we look like the board.
Yes, we did do that.
And we certainly did last night.
I think that we could have done that better. Maybe we'll do it better next year. I am not seeing where we adjourn one meeting and go to the other. The only adjournment I see, and this is 2 years ago, the only adjournment I see is to adjourn or to recess in order for the Australian ballot to happen. But I guess I don't. Anyway.
Yeah, but there's no recess of this board for the Australian ballot because that was
correct,
last night's
there
board.
Is none. That's right. That is right. Okay, so we're going to start the annual meeting. We're going to take questions, but I know we got to adjourn first.
Yeah,
see, that's what I thought is 6:30 too.
I'm just saying, in case other people want to come, they're
That's
public.
Right.
You can't.
That's why I thought this was till 6:30.
You can't start until 6:30, but this one was supposed to be over at 6 o'clock.
That's why I thought this was till 6:30, because that one didn't start till 6:30. I assumed it would be. Okay, got it.
So I think you're right, actually, because I'm looking at the minutes from last year, too, and it says, hearing no other business, moderator Ross recessed the meeting until Tuesday, March 1st, 2016, and turned the meeting over to the board for the budget hearing.
Ah, okay.
Or budget informational meeting.
Okay.
So, but it was still, the board was still entertaining those questions.
They did that after the recess. We did that after the recess. That's what we missed last year, last night. Okay.
Right.
We did get questions. I don't think anybody went without their questions answered.
We went without our questions.
You did, okay. I apologize.
I have some, but I was waiting to that part.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
I kind of crept up, and I was like, oh, crap.
It didn't happen.
Well, thank you for coming back, and I'm sorry. I'm sure that's my error.
It wasn't anybody's fault. I just was assuming it was run like it has been for many years.
Yeah, like 25 now.
Thank you.
And waited my time, and then went, whoops.
Shoot. Well, thank you for your patience. Thanks for coming back, and we'll get it, what we can do.
I would move that we adjourn this meeting.
Second.
Yes. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Pass. Okay, we're adjourned. Bathroom break.
Just to see if they kick doors again.
All right, so I'm going to call this annual meeting.
Click here for more details.
Vergennes Union High School District Number 5 annual meeting to order. We don't have a warning to read. It was read last night, but I will entertain nominations for the moderator for this annual meeting.
I'd like to nominate Jay Stetzel from Waltham.
Thank you, Rose.
Second.
Thank you, Greg. Are there any other nominations? Hearing none, the clerk will be instructed to cast one ballot for Jay Stetzel for moderator.
I got it.
Oh, yeah. Yep, it's over there.
Okay.
And then you scroll down.
Yeah, what you need there. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay. Passes. Thank you.
Thank you for that job, Dick. Great job.
This is the last time I'm doing this. It's been a wonderful ride, but I appreciate the fact that we now have a school district and all that good stuff. So we do not need to. Do we need to take nominations for a clerk?
No.
I don't think we do. I'll run the annual meeting at this point. So treasurer was nominated for the school district last night. Thank you, Greg, for accepting that nomination, and that passed. So basically, is there any other business that we need to transact for our annual meeting? Any other information, people? Any other public comments that people might have?
Is the questioning time?
Sure.
Public comment questions.
So I'll ask my high school question first. The director of maintenance, I know, is in the district budget now. So our maintenance director of the high school is eliminated, but there's an 18% increase in the custodians. What is that 18%? So from this year to next year, in the high school budget under custodian?
We hired a new custodian this year because we lost two custodians over the last 2 years. And we also had a custodian who was on leave for quite a while this year. So we do have an increase in custodians, but we are still understaffed and down by one custodian here. Probably the other increases reflect just salary increases, right? Yep.
So Mr. Worley's position's gone, and we are only having custodians, no leader or?
There may be that, Nancy. When the new director of buildings and grounds gets hired, It seems to work well that each of the buildings already have like a head custodian, but that's not a major expense. That might be additional duty type of an expense. The lion's share of the work that needs to be done at the, I mean, the individual's gonna have an office here, and the lion's share of the work is gonna be done here. The benefit, as we see it, is really around purchasing, around working as a team, and moving around the schools to complete projects as a team, to make sure that the staff has different certifications, so that like HVAC or electrical, we can use people across the district. We might be able to cut down on substitutes if we could share in staff. So it's that kind of coordination and really working more as a team than isolated buildings.
Thank you. So that's a question that leads into my district-wide question, which is, I believe you have a substitute coordinator for $9,000, and that's what you're saying, so there will be a person hired that coordinates?
We currently have a sub-coordinator for three of the five schools. It's not going to be any additional money. We moved the expense from a couple of schools to now one location, and it will be the same person. It'll be Diane Marcotte.
Under technology, it says teacher / tech assistant. Is it a teacher, or is it just a tech assistant?
Yeah, it's a tech assistant.
There's health and wellness stipend salary for $4,800. Is that a new position?
It's not a new position. Lynn Rappaport is currently our wellness and staff. What is the? I'm sorry, prevention and wellness coordinator. Her salary comes out of, the lion's share of her salary comes out of some of the federal and state grants. It's a very small portion that will also go to her salary.
Okay. So on federal and state, there's a line item for site-based clinicians.
Yeah.
Is that also federally funded?
It's not, there were a number previous to this year, or actually leading up to this year, there was always a part of the central office budget that was assessed back to the schools for school-wide services. One were the school-based clinicians, and that's our CSAC contract. So you have people that work with kids. Instead of having the expense at the school, they've always been at the district level. So is the literacy teachers, so of teachers that work under the grants, the federal grants that we get. And so school-based clinicians is that group.
So last year there was a decrease, but from this year to next year, it's a 14.5% increase.
So last year it was a decrease. As you know, we lost a clinician. I don't think we replaced fully. And this year they're charging us more because their Medicaid matches more. We're also seeing less, some of that expense had been offset by grants, our local Medicaid grants, and we're seeing less of that availability, so it's more of an expense.
Are these the people who work one-on-one with students, or are they the adults in the building called school-based clinicians who
Correct.
See people all at most kids that fit under the Medicaid thing? Okay, so it's not the individual.
Not the BIs.
Okay.
And I have one last question. Thank you for your patience. The director of student services and the office staff each got increases. Who decides if what your raise is in the central office?
So that doesn't need to be board approved. You can just...
The board approves the budget.
Yeah, so that's how it's approved. Through you decide a raise and then they approve. Not you, because you're...
District.
Yes.
You're public.
Thank you.
Those were all my questions. Thank you very much.
I had about 20 questions, but I was told by Joanne to send them to her. So I did, and they were all answered. So I just wanted you to know that there were some questions in those individual budgets, and that's why I mentioned it
last night. Did I answer them appropriately, Rose?
Well, except for the two that you couldn't, and then Stephanie chimed in, and then somehow you two got together and figured out that that wrong thing was there. So
yeah.
That's why that probably several of those questions were there. So, but yes, you did.
Thank you.
I was very satisfied with all the questions.
Yeah, thank you.
But I just feel that, and I know all of you won't be on this SD board next year, but somehow all of those budgets somehow needs to be available. And I know online seems like it's fair, but I think when you have the annual budget, you could also have copies of those if people wanted to pick that up when they come to get that. Mm-hmm. If because that's the only way, unless all those things are going to be in one budget, I mean, like all teacher salaries are going to be in one budget, then have a copy of that individualized papers. So, because otherwise, people have no clue by looking at that little book that what their line items are.
Right.
So it makes for confusion, all I have to say about that.
So go ahead, Tom.
Well, I was just going to say, and the confusion actually leads to suspicion.
Yes.
And
well, that's why I emailed 20 questions. So I was like, okay, what's going on?
But they were answered. One thing I'd like to say, just because I'm new, this is my first time being a board member at an annual meeting. It's been a really valuable experience to be on this board the last year, especially moving into being on the SD board. Having those two board experiences together has been very helpful. It's been really helpful to both learn from the rest of you, but also to get to work with the three of you in different capacities over on the facilities committee and the board. And I think the reason why I think it's worth saying this is because I think it's easy to see the conflictual nature of you know, some of the issues that are involved, because there's money involved, there's kids involved, there's anxiety over the building that's involved. I feel a lot of anxiety over the building, and I don't work here. And I appreciate the way that the principal and the superintendent and the business manager have been extremely open to questions. Sometimes those questions are rude. Sometimes my questions are always rude. Sometimes they're rude. Sometimes they're always well-intentioned, and they have taken them in a well-intentioned fashion. And I think that it's really important that we remember that we're on the same team. And you know, this is towards the SD board too. That we're here because we care about the community and we care about the school. And I appreciate that over the last year. So that's all.
I think to add to that, though, not that I'm a board member, but that we're all here for the same reason, for our students.
Yeah.
And I think that's the most important reason any of you are here, is because you care about kids. And why we're all here. Mm-hmm. And I think that is sometimes forgotten underneath the stress and the pressure. And we think about, oh, can we afford this? Can we afford that? But just like somebody was talking about last night, without the school system, we'd have how many kids going hungry every year? I mean, every day. Mm-hmm. And it's just scary to me because I see it on a daily basis. Can I have an apple? Can I have your snack? I didn't bring one from home. So, yeah, take it. I don't care. But it's the kids. And I really appreciate all of you as much as you do for them.
Thank you.
Any other comments or questions?
Did we give you an applause for your last time?
No. It's not necessary. Thank you, though, Ron.
We'll find another job.
I'm sure they will.
I've got plenty, George. I don't need any more. But I appreciate your thought. So hearing no other questions or comments, I'll adjourn the meeting. I don't think we need to take a motion to adjourn. So.
You have the power.
Yeah. As moderator, I'll adjourn the annual meeting.
Thank you.
Thank you. Nice work, Jay.